Good morning. Bo, please read the problem, and Billy, please translate.
Flippin' physics.
A 453-gram toy car moving at 1.05 meters per second is going over a semicircular hill with a radius of 1.8 meters.
Please stop. The mass of the car equals 453 grams, which we multiply by 1 kilogram over 1,000 grams to convert to 0.453 kilograms. The speed of the car is 1.05 meters per second.
Actually, Billy, that is the magnitude of the tangential velocity of the car, because the car is moving along a circle.
Right, that makes sense. Thanks. And the radius of the circle is 1.8 meters. Bo?
When the car is at the top of the hill, what is the magnitude of the force from the ground on the car?
The force from the ground on the car is the force normal. So force normal equals question mark.
Great. Bobby, what do we do next?
Well, we are solving for a force, so do we draw a free body diagram and sum the forces?
Yes, but before we do, let's review my 5 steps to help solve any free body diagram problem. Class, step 1 is...
Draw the free body diagram.
Step 2...
Break forces into components.
Step 3...
Redraw the free body diagram.
Step 4...
Sum the forces.
And step 5...
Sum the forces again.
Correct. Remember, step 5 is to sum the forces in a direction perpendicular to the direction in step 4. Bobby, please begin.
The force normal is up, and the force of gravity is down. That's it. So there are no forces to break into components, so we could skip doing that, and we could skip redrawing the free body diagram. The net force in the y direction equals force normal minus force of gravity, which equals mass times acceleration in the y direction, and the acceleration in the y direction equals zero, so the force normal equals the force of gravity. We know the equation for the force of gravity. It equals
hold
mass.
Hold up, Bobby. I don't think what you're doing is right.
Of course it is. We've seen this free body diagram an innumerable number of times, and the force normal always equals the force of gravity.
But we have not done this with an object moving in a circle before.
Oh. Bo is correct. Be careful. The car is moving in a circle, which means the y direction is not the correct direction to sum the forces in. Billy, in what direction do we need to sum the forces in?
The in direction. We need to sum the forces in the in direction. Nice.
Correct. Whenever an object is moving in a circle, you need to identify where that circle is so you can identify what direction the in direction is. In this case, the car is moving in a vertical circle, and therefore when the car is at the top of the hill, the in direction is straight down. Bobby, please sum the forces in the in direction.
Okay, the net force in the in direction equals force normal minus force of gravity, which equals mass times acceleration in the in direction.
And what is the acceleration in the in direction called?
Centripetal acceleration.
I thought in was positive and out was negative. So the force of gravity should be positive and the force normal should be negative, right?
That is correct. Students are so used to summing the forces in the y direction that this is a common mistake. Remember, we are summing the forces in the in direction, and inward is positive and outward is negative. Bo, in this example at the top of the hill, what is the centripetal force acting on the car?
Isn't that just the force inward, so the force of gravity?
No, the centripetal force is the net force in the in direction.
Right. So the centripetal force, or the net force in the in direction, is the force of gravity minus the force normal.
Yes. Remember, the centripetal force is made up of other forces, because it is the sum of the forces in the in direction. And in this specific situation, the centripetal force is the force of gravity minus the force normal. Bobby, please continue solving the problem.
Okay, force of gravity, or mass times acceleration due to gravity, minus force normal equals mass times... Well, we can substitute tangential velocity squared over radius for the centripetal acceleration. We are solving for the force normal. So subtract mass times acceleration due to gravity from both sides. And now multiply the whole equation by negative 1 to get force normal equals mass times acceleration due to gravity minus mass times tangential velocity squared over radius. We can substitute in numbers to get 0.453 times 9.81 minus 0.453 times 1.05 squared divided by 1.8, which is 4.1665 or 4.2 newtons with two significant digits.
Now, an important thing to realize here is how the magnitude of the force normal compares to the magnitude of the force of gravity. The force of gravity acting on the car is roughly 4.4 newtons, which means the force normal is less than the force of gravity.
You know, you can feel that, right?
Hello, Kit.
Who is that?
What? Everybody, this is Kit from Gorilla Physics.
Hi, chaps.
Yo, what up?
Hi.
Okay, Kit, now, I know what you mean, but could you please explain yourself a little bit more?
Yeah, no bother. Well, as you go over the crest of a hill, you feel like you weigh less because you feel less of a normal reaction force from the ground. And the faster you go, the less of the reaction force you'll feel. You know that funny feeling like your stomach's rising. But it's fun. It's like on a roller coaster when you go over the top of a crest. The normal reaction force is less, so you feel as if you weigh less.
I love that feeling. I love roller coasters.
Me too. They are so much fun.
Kit, thank you very much for your help.
Yeah, my pleasure. Thanks.
Okay. This idea that the force normal decreases the faster you drive the car over the hill is one we are going to explore further in our next lesson. Until then, thank you very much for learning with us today. We enjoyed learning with you.